Hey everyone, Rodney here at Cleves Tech, and today I'm going to show you how to get text like this with Fooocus. This will work with other Stable Diffusion tools, but I'll be using Fooocus for this video. So instead of text like this, you can have text like this. I'll show you three different methods that can be used. If you're not familiar with inpainting or image prompts in Fooocus, I do recommend checking those videos I have out first, because we will be using them. So you've probably gone ahead, you've tried to generate images like this one here. I tried to put, hello, my name is Tanya, and I did not get that one bit. A lot of times you can keep on trying to regenerate using inpainting, but you're not gonna usually get anything long text-wise. I can show you how to get it like this, and that's what I'm gonna show you today. There is several different methods on how you can do this. I'm gonna show you every single way that I know of that I use. I use them all in different combinations because each method doesn't always work exactly how I want. So if one doesn't work, I'll switch over to using another one. So the easiest way to do this, to start off with, this was the image we had originally. So that's the one we want to start with. We're going to mask off the area in the inpainting that we want to regenerate. Now, if you're not familiar with inpainting, I do recommend watching one of my other videos on inpainting because we are going to be using inpainting in this video. I also will be covering the image prompts as well. So if you're not familiar with that, you may want to freshen up on those. Okay, so we have our area masked off that we want inpainted. So the next step we have is to go to the image prompt, and we're going to want that checked off for the advanced section. What I already did, but I'll show you, I went into for this, I used Adobe Express. You can use any image editor you want for these things. And I just took the image, I created a white background on the board area, and then I just put some text over it. The reason for doing that is it makes it a lot easier for Fooocus to see what text that you want to transfer over. If you didn't do that, it wouldn't work quite as well. Then I just went ahead and downloaded that image, and I will take that, drop it into there. Now, the key thing to this that you have to remember is whenever you're working in any other program, do not change the resolution for this method. For this method I'm showing you here, you want this image in the image prompt area to be the same resolution and size as the one that you're working on. Otherwise, this will not work. And I'll show you how to do it differently otherwise, because you can do it with different sizes, but we'll get into that after. Now, I prefer CPDS in most cases, but sometimes the Pyro Candy might work try both if they don't. Setting the stop at, what'll happen is if you have too low of a stop at, that text will start to fall apart. So you wanna find a nice area where it changes and fits it into the background, into the image, but you also don't want it to completely fall apart. Now that we have our image prompt set up, ready to go, we have our inpainting area ready to go. We've masked the area we want to generate. Okay. The one other thing to be aware of here is we do have to be in the developer debug mode for this method, and we are going to change a setting in there. If we were to generate this right now, I'm going to show you what would happen just so you understand why you have to change this. Once you see why this happens, it'll make more sense why we do some of the stuff I'm going to show you, because this will not work by default. Okay, as you can see here, it's already not working. And the reason for that is if you look at the image up here, it's only working on a portion of that image, not the full image. Therefore, this image prompt is not lining up. That's our problem here. Now, there is a way around that. So we're gonna hit stop. And in the debug settings, we have this setting called inpaint respective field. And that determines how much of the area that is worked on. So the default setting is to work on the area you have masked and then a certain size portion of the image around it. But it's not working on the whole image. So when it does the inpainting and brings in the image prompts, everything gets out of whack and those things don't line up. Now, in order to do it this way, if we want to, we want to move this slider all the way up to 1, because that tells it we want it to work with the whole image. Normally, it would zoom in, upscale it, fiddle, do what it does, generate, and then bring it back and put it back into the image. But for this method, we're not going to be doing it that way. We're going to go to completely using the whole image. That way, when it does this, all that stuff is going to line up. Now, this also won't work for certain things, which I'll show you momentarily. But let's go ahead and generate now and see the difference. Now, at this point, I wouldn't be fully satisfied with that, but it's pretty close. Now, so what I could do in here is I could just adjust that a little more if I wanted to. I could also do in white chalk to make it look more like it was on a chalkboard. And there we go. We have our text. Now, you can play around with fonts. You can play around with any of that sort of stuff. But and as you adjust this, if we want it more creative, we could lower this down to see if it carries over. The problem you're going to run into is any text that if you use a font that's thin and not thick and bold, it's going to have a harder time keeping that structure of the text. As you can see here, it started to fall apart because we lowered that, the CPDS level, the stop at, so it doesn't have the influence as it goes through. So you want to play around with those. Now, these aren't my greatest images. I'm just wanted to demonstrate the technique. Okay, so for the next method, a little bit different. We're going to keep all the settings the same for the most part. I'm going to go with the InPaint. I've adjusted this way down instead of way up because we're not going to do the whole image this time. Because if we try to do the whole image, if we're just going to do the name tag here, is what I'm going to show, that won't carry over because the text will be too small and it's just not going to work. So instead of doing the InPaint respective field as one, I'm going to go way down. I'm not going to go all the way down because I do want it to do a little bit around it, but I'm going to, and you may find you need to adjust this as you work on it, but we're going to be working on just a smaller area. Now, I do need to find out what that smaller area is. So that's the first challenge involved here. So what I'm going to do is go ahead before I do anything and InPaint the area that I want to work on. There we go. So that's the area we want to work on. We won't do anything at this point. We just need to generate because we need to find out a piece of information. Now, when we go to do that, we're going to watch in here as in your command window. You're going to see here it says image upscaling image with 303, 303. So that actually ended up being an exact square. So that's all we needed here was a 303, 303 resolution. I'm going to go ahead and stop that. Now, in my image editing, I'm going to go in and I'm going to use Adobe Express for this. And the size on this one was 303, 303. So, and I've gone ahead and just created this here. Now, it's probably going to take a couple tries to figure out exactly if I've got this set up exactly how I want it. And I'm going to change the background all white at this point. We're going to go into the image prompt area like we did before. I'm going to bring this in here. Now, I haven't tested this, so let's hope that it works. Put it on CPDS again. Yeah, we'll go with like a 6 point something to start off with. Now, usually this takes a couple tries just to figure out roughly what I'm going for. And we can change some of the prompt because I don't really need all this stuff. And I find sometimes it's better just to reduce the prompt. So let's go ahead and try generating that, see what happens. It zooms in and creates at a much higher resolution. And then it'll rescale it down and fit it into the image. It's the same technique that is used when it's doing the improved detail in focus. It'll work on a higher quality at this point. That resolution it's actually working on is a higher resolution, the latent image. And then it'll scale it back down and fit it into that 303 by 303 chunk that it was working on. But what it did originally was it zoomed in, upscaled it, fit it in. Okay, I'm going to stop that because I think you get the idea here. We don't need to generate a bunch of images, so I'm going to head and stop that. We could describe it better if we wanted to, but I think you get a good idea that this does work, and you get much better text this way. If we go in and we zoom in on the image, you'll see that it blends in much better. Sometimes if you're working in an area that's a little too large, or if it's right at the edge, that's not gonna work as easily. Depending on what it's working with, that doesn't always work. If it's right next to the edge or things like that, it carries over into that other off the edge border or something like that. I'm not entirely sure, but this works for the most part. If it's not really close to the edge, if it's a smaller area, if we are doing a much bigger area here and we wanted to zoom in, that may not work as well. And that's where my next method comes in. And that's not as accurate. It's more of eyeballing it when you work with the image. And I'm also going to show you how to do the perspective stuff as well. So what if that text isn't straight? We're going to use this image here for the last method. It's one I had tried to create the other day. And of course, the signs did not come out how I wanted. Now, same idea on this one. We're going to use a lower amount for the InPaint respective field. And let's start off. We're going to be masking the sign up here. Now, you may ask, why not do it the other way? Well, where this is right next to the edge, it's not going to do well because it won't work and it will be mismatched. So I don't know the explanation for why, so I'm not even going to try to explain why it doesn't work, just that it won't in this sort of circumstance. So now that I know the masked area that I want to work on, I'm going to go ahead and hit the generate button just to get a rough idea of where this is going to be working on. Now, what I usually do at this point is I just take a screenshot when it starts to do it. Easiest way that I've found is I just go ahead, I take a screenshot, get a rough idea of where it's going to be generating, then I hit stop because I just need to know that. So now I have my rough idea of where it's going to be working on. Now, then I open my image in GIMP. You can use whichever tool that you prefer that can do what you want, but for my purposes, this is what I'm familiar with. So I'm going to work with this. So for what we're working on, that's perfect enough. I just need a base there. We're going to be regenerating all that anyways. Then I'm going to choose my text. We got it how we want it. Now I'm going to take my perspective tool. And this is where the trick comes in for these. And I may not get this perfect for the video, so don't criticize me. Okay, so now I have my text on where I want it for this. Now I need to figure out where to crop this. So I will keep this on a separate screen. This is where multiple screens come into play. Now, it may not be exact. And if that's the case, we can always come back and edit it and things like that. But looking at this, I get a pretty good idea that's exactly where that is. So I'm just going to hit enter at this point. And we are all done with that for the moment. Okay, so now we have our section to throw into the image prompt here. So I'll drop that into there. We're going to put on the CPDS. Okay, well, I got the text in here already, so that's fine. I don't need to change anything there. Okay, I think we're ready to give this a shot. Okay, so on that run, it didn't do that good of a job, so we're going to have to adjust those settings a little bit, I think. So let's go ahead, because it didn't get all the letters in there. So let's go into our image prompt here. And I am going to do the stop at, and you can also adjust things like the weight. The problem is sometimes is those letters can merge together as we saw. Let's hit generate again. Okay. And we have our signs and it actually did a pretty good job overall. I didn't give it any information on how I wanted it to look, so I kind of let it go with its own. This one, the A got a little messed up, and a lot of this also does depend on the font that you choose. So I'm gonna go with this one. I like that one. It's not 100% perfect, but it's good enough for me. Now, obviously, once you're done with one section, and if you want to do more, then you would bring that down. We're going to clear that off. And we can do the same thing if we want to add more to another section and go through the same process. Okay, now that I've gone ahead and I figured out where that was going to process the next one, I've gone ahead and edited, so I'm going to remove that. Now, using a slightly different image that I was working on, but this will give us our next section. Now we can do it. Yeah, we're going to stop that. So let's go with purple neon lights. That's what I want to try. Okay, and we have our signs. Let's see here. Now, let's go with that one. I like that one. We're going to bring that one down in, and we're going to clear that area. And last but not least, we're going to do this sign down here just for fun. I'm going to zoom in a little more on that. Okay, and now for our last sign. I've got the measurements. I cropped it out. And we're going to bring in that last one here. There we go. And change what this says. Okay. Now I got the colors reversed, but it got the text. I think for our purposes, that pretty much gives us what we want. I mean, I'm not sure which one is better in my opinion. Well, I like that one. And then the final step, and we can get rid of all the others. We can go in, we can upscale it and generate, and we have our final image. Now with those three methods, you should be able to get text almost anywhere you want in your images, even those small areas. Now remember, if you're using thin fonts, you may have more difficulty, or handwriting fonts as well. Hopefully you found this video helpful and you would consider hitting the like button or even buying me a coffee. I do want to thank the people who have. Thanks for watching and have fun creating.